Hey, hey, hey guys, and welcome to a redstone tutorial with me, Iskall. Today we are gonna build a multi-furnace smelter machine. Automated, of course, and this is something that is needed in every survival world, at least for me. This is one of the first things I build when I set up base. And this is how it's gonna look like. We have three chests and we have a fuel indicator up here. So let me demo how this works. In the middle chest you're going to want to put what you want to smelt. For this demo I'm going to put in 8 iron ore. In this chest here you'll put your fuel, and at the moment you can see that this thing is loaded. We've got some fuel in there, but just for the sake of this demo I'm going to put in some more. Now here's the next magic thing about this machine is waiting. So this will smelt all the iron and it will produce it or put it in this chest here. So that's our 8 iron back, and there we go. If we have a look behind the scenes, as you can see, this is not a mega big thing either. You can easily fit this if you live in a cave like I do. And if you live in a big house, you'd have to be a bit creative around how to hide this. But don't fear, guys, this may look a bit complicated, but it's really simple. And we're going to build it today, and I'm going to talk a bit how it works and why it works. As always, I hope to be able to teach you some redstone, as well as give you a cool new machine for your base. So let's get started. Okay, the first thing you want to do is place down your furnaces, because it does use furnaces, and for this demo we're gonna make it 8, just like that. And you can actually extend this. The redstone wiring travels 16 blocks, so you could potentially do about 14. We're gonna need the last 2 for transferring power, but I'll do 8 in this demo. After you place your furnaces down, go ahead and stick some hoppers on top of them, just like so, and just repeat that one more time, like that. That's going to be our smelting input belt on the back of the furnace. Very important that it's on the back. Go ahead and do the same facing inwards, so that you got hoppers going inwards and these go straight down. Put a second row just like this facing downwards to them hoppers. If I look from the side, that's how it looks. Now, the next thing you want to do is get a block going like so, and here as well, remove that block and do a third hopper belt line just like so. So these are facing inwards towards that block. Do the same here, and our feeder belt is done. Next, let's create our output line just like this, facing that way, below these furnaces, just like that, and that's going to be our output coming this way. Okay, now we want to make sure that we distribute things equally. We want to make sure that both the ingredients that we're smelting as well as the fuel gets distributed evenly. To do that, go ahead and place a line of blocks just like that, one out from the midline, and do the same thing on this fuel belt down here. So just go out one, place blocks, and now go ahead and stick some redstone torches all the way like that. These torches are going to freeze this hopper here, the middle line hopper. Do the same thing on this side, so just freezing them. I think I missed one. Yeah, I did. Very good, very good. The reason we have these placed like that is so that we can evenly distribute the material that we are working with. To do that, we need to unfreeze these hoppers whenever an item reaches the last hopper. So that's this one for the input item and this one for the fuel item. Go ahead and place down blocks like this. Onto those, you want to put a comparator just like that. Go out with a block like so and go up one and up one. Now, place a repeater down like that so that we always have power into this block when there is an item in there. From there, I want to place a torch like that, and I also want this line to come around the bend like so. And oop, don't want to place comparator, but redstone dust going all the way over to that line there. Now, whenever an item comes in this hopper here, it's going to unload or unfreeze all the hoppers below here. It's that's also gonna unpower this torch. We'll come back to that in a second, and just do the same here. So blocks goes around and we take power from that block all the way over to unfreeze the hoppers for the fuel part. Okay, we needed these torches here because we also need to bring this power upwards to align freezing the input or feeding belt. And the way we do that is by placing down blocks like this. So a block above the torch powers this block that has this torch on it that will power at the moment this block, or at the moment it won't power this block, but once we send a pulse in it will power this block here. Now from the fuel line, and this is very important, start with the fuel line here and do a block coming like so, so, and then go redstone dust just like that, and then bring it over to here. This is gonna freeze the feeder belt whenever an item reaches over here, and I'll show you why we need to do this. Now, the other one here is gonna be a bit different. First, place a block down like that, exactly what you did there, but now you need to go slabs on the top level like this, all the way over to the first one like so, and go ahead and place redstone dust onto these slabs like that. Now there's a connection here, we do not want the connection here, so go ahead and break it just like that. Place a block on top of this dust, breaking the power. Okay, I see that I forgot to place the dust down there and also cut that power there. So what's going to happen now is that this torch is going to pulse, send a redstone signal into this, which is going to get the redstone dust over here powered and freeze these hoppers. So let me demo what happens. If I put in into our input belt, I'll put in 8 iron ores. They will start traveling over, and once it reaches the end, it blinks, allowing them to go through and evenly distributing them into our furnaces here, as you can see. Now, all this redstone that we just did, and the reason we use 3 layers of hoppers is to be able to control the even distribution. If we would have only 2 lines of hoppers, we could achieve the same thing. Say that this line would be facing this way and this line would be removed, but if we then input different things into the machine at once, which you want to do, you want to bulk smelt things, things are going to get stuck when the feeder or when the input hoppers are frozen below. So that's why we want 3 lines of hopper going in a band like that. Next, let's start designing this thing, because as far as function goes, this machine is working properly at the moment. This being your input, this being your fuel input, and this being your output. Before we get to install any cool indicator lights for the fuel, I want to make sure to mark out where our front panel should be, and I just placed 3 hoppers out, 3 hoppers out to give us some space to drag that redstone. And onto these hoppers, I want to have my input chest. So let me grab a normal chest, and let me also grab a trap chest. It's very important that you use the trap chest in your middle line, which is going to be your input, and the normal chest for the fuel input. That's important because when we build the item tower up here, if you use a trap chest on that, you're going to lock the item tower when looking in it. So if you want the chests stacked next to each other like this, please put the trap chest in the middle, otherwise you'll have issues later. Alright, from here we want to go up, up, and up here we want to install our indicator lights. For my demo or for my build, I want to use 5 indicator lights like that. Remember, we'll have a 3rd chest here, so this will be centered. You can use more lights and you'll get even more indication of how much fuel you have, but that's up to you. Okay, the next thing that we want to do now we have got this marked out is just to put down some floor like that, so that we can see what we're doing. and go all the way down here and have a look at this hopper here. Now this hopper is going to be our indicator for the fuel. I've put in some iron ore there just to be sure that it doesn't go in. There's nothing wrong with the build. I could exchange that for coal and you'll see that it will start to drop in. I just want to make sure we have something in there so that we easily can see what we do. Okay, from there you need to go get some blocks going so that you can put down a comparator into redstone dust, into new comparator, into redstone dust. This pattern here is what we're going to use all the way up to our panel up here. And let's come back up here and put down some blocks like this that we can put some dust on. And when we power these, we're going to start to get indicators or the lights going for the indication. So basically, we just need to bring all of this up to here. And I have it set from left to right. You could do whatever you'd like. The reason we do this pattern with a comparator dust is to keep the signal strength that the comparator reads from the container. Now, if we just go dust like this, you can see that already here with them 24 iron ores, we're going to lose power. And we want that effect, but we don't want it down here. We want it up there. So that's the way to do it, guys. Now, this line is a bit tricky to place out because you need to be careful not interfering with the other redstone that we have going on, for example, here and on top of these hoppers. So, let's see. Let's put down some blocks like so. As you can see, you can turn the signal around as well by making sure to put the comparator facing into a block above it. It's going to power that block and the dust above it. We can just continue this pattern like so. Go up like that and just get this going. This may prove to be an issue because this would actually interfere with our dropper or hopper right there. Sorry, I always mix up hoppers and droppers. I'm gonna remove this. Sorry if you already started to do that. I'm gonna put go out one more and then do redstone like that instead. This is what you get when I record raw without any cutscenes, and hopefully you can appreciate that. Like that, and just continue the pattern and we should be fine. Let's actually have a look. So we want to make sure that we do not have any block with redstone directly above these hoppers because they're gonna power them, but that should be good. So let's do redstone dust comparator, dust comparator, dust comparator, and this lets us have the signal all the way up. Now from here I think we can go out one. Let's see. Oops. Already we are powering a block that's powering the lights, and it's this block here. So we need to rethink that quickly and go over here instead. Just like so. And we should be good for not interfering with them slabs there. So same pattern goes around. It's a bit tricky this here, but it does give you the awesome feature of indication for how much fuel you have, which I can really enjoy. You can also turn it by doing that, and from here just hook it up, and as you can see, that iron ore in the fuel line gives me an indication that there's fuel in there, and it's only going to give me an indication once this machine here is full of coal. So if I go ahead and fill it, it's still gonna be nothing, and then put in 64 coal. I think we'll have two lit. Yep, we'll have two lit, and continue this to fill it up. We'll get even more lights. Oh, that's actually giving us a fully fueled machine already from two stacks. Now there is a way to make this a bit more sensitive, and that's making sure that you put spacing between these so that the lines only triggers a lamp each other. But for me this is very helpful. I think that's enough fuel to get you going for quite some time, and I just need an indication of how much I have. So if you now imagine that our front panel would come like this, we can easily hide all this redstone and none of it will be visible in the final build. Alright, let's go ahead and install our item tower, and for that we're gonna need droppers. Them droppers, and let's get rid of that slab for now. So come down here, mark out where the output chest is gonna be for this build here. I want it right next to the input one, so I'm gonna go down and come up to the same level as this this hopper here, and then look down and jump. I'm flying in creative here, but for survival, jump and place shift place droppers like that, and you'd be fine. Right, that's going to be our output. Go ahead and stick a normal chest on it. Again, you do not want to use a trap chest because then you're going to lock this and mess a bit with the item tower. From here, simply connect up the hoppers, and I actually mismeasured that, so I'm going to need to remove that block there and place another dropper facing upwards, just like that. So in total for this design, it's going to be 5 droppers. How you drag this output line is of course up to you. I use this to be able to fit some redstone down, because from here you want to come up 2 blocks so that you can reach these hoppers and place down a comparator onto that hopper there. So the hopper that feeds into the dropper should be the one giving us our signal, our clock, and our engine for this item tower. From it, go repeater like that into block and into dust, just like that. That will give us a clock. It will also freeze this to make sure that our hoppers are working at the same pace and speed as our droppers. Now put a block down like that and go a redstone repeater. I think also we need to delay this clock a bit. Now timings, as always, is a bit different if you play multiplayer Minecraft, so be aware, test this back and forth and make sure that you get the timings correct to you. Go ahead and stick a torch on there. That torch is going to come off when we have this clock cycling, and power that repeater there. This repeater is going to power this this dropper and this dropper. Very important. So from that dropper there, go ahead and place down blocks like that. Do the same on this dropper here, and stick repeaters in there and there. Very good. We're gonna have a look at the timings later, see how this works out. From here, put a torch down there, block onto that torch, another torch there, and another torch there with a block on top of it. Very good. Go ahead and put a torch there, so you got a torch on the other side, unlit torches, just like that. Very good. Now just put down some redstone dust like this, and that's a functioning item tower. Now I wanted to show you how this looks like in the normal item tower build. However, because of this design, we have a hopper going over here underneath this chest, that hopper there. That hopper is now going to be frozen by this item tower, so unfortunately you need to remove this repeater and this dust, place a block there, and go a repeater here instead. That repeater is now going to power this block and this dropper, but it's not going to touch our hopper here, so we'll still be able to input items. Right, what you want to do now is to make sure that you have some delay on this repeater up here, and we're going to make it 3 ticks just like that, and this item tower should be ready to go. We can test it by putting items into this hopper here. I'll put in 6 coal, and let's see if we get all of them up to our chest. 5, 6, very good. There are numerous ways to do item towers. I like to use this method of repeaters with torches, and not only torches, because I feel that gets the least items stuck in the tower. I saw another thing here That's very important. Go ahead and make sure that that hopper for our output is facing that hopper so that the items travel out. All right, let's see if this design works. First of all, we have fuel, but I think we manually fed the fuel into the first one there. So let's check. Yes, we do have some fuel in there. Let's come over here, put in... Oh, of course, we can't have solid blocks above. There's a trick that you can use stairs facing the other way to get the design that I have going over there. Let's put in 8 iron ores and just have a look at what's going on. So they feed into here, they blink, means that they drop down into the furnaces just like that, and they are currently smelting. Very good. On our last coal there. Now the reason there's 63 in here is that we had manual input into this one earlier. So, oops, something just fell off my desk. I apologize for that. Let's have a look. We got 8 iron ingots in the chest, and that is you done with this build. Now, to hide the redstone, you can just build around like this and like that, and put a line nicely like that. I'd also recommend you to go behind the chests, otherwise the hoppers will be visible. Put down some blocks like that, and I'm gonna show you the stairs trick real quick. Let's do oak stairs. If you put stairs like this, they are gonna look like full blocks from the front here, but they're really half blocks, so you'll still be able to open up the chests. Very nice, very good. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial. For me, this is a very important build in any survival game, in any base that I build. So much smelting of stuff that you need to do, coming back from the mine, getting your iron in here, getting your gold in here, even stone, and just leaving it be while you sort your items or do anything else. Is a very nice function to have. Right guys, I am glad to have you with me. I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more, and have a great day guys. Bye bye.